Hello students, I am Abha Singh. Today our topic is half-wave rectifier. We know all the electronic circuits need a DC voltage for their operation. For this purpose, we have to use a regulated DC power supply. The block diagram of regulated power supply is shown in the figure. The basic building blocks of a regulated power supply are a step-down transformer, a rectifier, filter and a voltage regulator. A step-down transformer is used to reduce the AC main voltage to an adequately small value. This voltage is converted into pulsating DC by the rectifier, and there are two types of rectifier, half-wave rectifier and full-wave rectifier. The pulsating DC at the rectifier output is converted into a ripple-free steady DC voltage by the filter circuit. The filter DC voltage is then applied to a voltage regulator, which tries to keep the DC output voltage constant even if there is a change in supply voltage or there is a fluctuation in load. In this lecture, we will study half-wave rectifier. The rectifier is a circuit which converts an alternating DC voltage into direct voltage. We can classify the rectifier circuit into two types, half-wave rectifier and full-wave rectifier. Again, this full-wave rectifier can be classified into full-wave rectifier with center-tapped transformer and full-wave bridge rectifier. First, we discuss half-wave rectifier. The operation of the circuit of half-wave rectifier is shown in figure. And the operation of half-wave rectifier circuit is as follows. During the positive half cycle of AC supply, the secondary voltage VAB, this voltage is positive, that is A is positive with respect to B, and hence the diode is forward biased and starts conducting. As the diode starts conducting, the load voltage is thus positive and almost equal to the instantaneous secondary voltage VAB. The load current has the same shape as that of the load voltage, since the load is purely resistive. During negative half cycle, the secondary voltage VAB, this secondary voltage VAB is negative, and that is A is negative with respect to B. Hence, diode is reverse biased and it offers very high resistance, or we can replace it by an open circuit switch. The load is disconnected from secondary, hence the load current is zero and the output voltage is also zero. This circuit is called as a half-wave rectifier because it delivers power to the load during only one half cycle of the AC supply voltage. Analysis of half-wave rectifier. This is the output waveform of half-wave rectifier. In output waveform, during positive half cycle, load current is flowing, while during negative half cycle, there is no load current in the load. First parameter of half-wave rectifier is DC or average load current, ILDC. By the definition, the average value of periodic function is given by the area under one cycle of function divided by the base or the period. So, using this definition, value of IDC is given by 1 by 2 pi integration from 0 to pi Im sin omega t d omega t. And by solving this equation, we get the value of ILDC is equal to Im by pi, where Im is given by Vm by RS plus RF plus RL. RL is load resistance, RF is diode forward resistance, and RS is transformer secondary resistance. Second parameter is VLDC or average load voltage. VLDC is given by ILDC multiplied by RL, and it is given by Vm by pi. Next is AC or RMS load current. IL RMS is given by this formula. Solving this formula, we get the value of IL RMS value is equal to IM by 2 pi. Similarly, VL RMS is equal to VM by 2 pi. Next parameter is rectification efficiency. Rectification efficiency is denoted by eta and it is given by DC output power divided by AC input power. Substituting the values of I square DC, RL, IS, RMS square, value of substituting this value of IDC and IS, we get the this equation, and assuming that RL is much greater than RS plus RF, we get the value of eta is equal to 4 by pi square, which is equal to 0.4 or 40%. Ideally, maximum value of eta should be 100%, but for half-wave rectifier, maximum value of eta is to be small, and this is the biggest disadvantage of half-wave rectifier. Next is ripple factor. Ripple factor is given by RMS value of AC component of output divided by DC or average value of output. Ideally, the AC component of output should be 0. It means that ideal value of ripple factor should be 0, and practically it should be as small as possible. Substituting the value of VLRMS and VLDC, we get the value of ripple factor is 1.21 or 121%. Equation A indicates that the ripple content in the output is 1.21 times the DC component, and this is a very high value of ripple factor, which indicates that the output of half-wave rectifier is no way close to the pure DC voltage. A filter circuit is required to reduce ripple factor. Next is peak inverse voltage. Peak inverse voltage, this is the maximum negative voltage which appears across a non-conducting reverse bias diode. The maximum negative voltage across the diode, across this diode, is minus Vm volt, where when this diode is not conducting, hence peak inverse voltage is Vm volts. Disadvantages of half-wave rectifier: ripple factor is high, 1.21. Second, low rectification efficiency, approximately 40%. Third is low DC output voltage and current. And fourth one is larger filter components are required. Advantages: simple construction, simple size, and less number of components are required to be used. Application: it is used in for pocket radios, for Walkman, and for low cost power supply. Thank you.